Hey, we welcome you today. It's so good to know that you're watching, that you're participating with us, in fact, as we do these five-minute episodes throughout the week. We've been talking about the 21 days of prayer and fasting, and the Lord has led me to talk to us about comfort. And I thought in this time where there's so much going on with people talking about the end times, I believe that we are in the end times. In fact, I believe we're in the very much in the end of the end times. But we need to know that it's not for us to be afraid of. In the book of Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, Paul makes this statement in verse 11, and he says, "Therefore, comfort each other and edify one another." In essence, encourage each other, build one another up. He's talking to us and he's saying, this is not a time for us to be in fear. It really isn't a time for us to stockpile weapons and ammunitions and years and years of food supplies and all of that. It's a time for you and I to trust the Lord, to comfort one another in the discussions of life by saying God is faithful, to use the scripture to determine how this thing ought to go, and realize this, and always realize this, the church wins. In all circumstances and in all situations, we win. God has already established the victory. He says this here in verse number 9, if you will, "For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or asleep, whether we're alive or dead, we should live together with him." We are going to live with him. We live with him now. We're going to live with him throughout eternity. We're going to be with him just as surely as he's with us. He said he would deliver us out of all circumstances and situations, out of all troubles. Comfort one another today. Build one another up. Remember this, God is faithful. He has a plan that will take us out of the wrath that he's going to pour out. So we're not there yet. God's not opening the vials of revelations that are wrath and pouring them out yet. We'll be out of here before that happens, according to the scripture. I believe it with all my heart. So I want to take great comfort. Now, that's not to say we're going to be nonchalant. There are people that will go to hell if we don't do what we're supposed to do. There are people that will be lost for eternity. So it's our job to begin to declare the comfort of God, the promise of God, the fullness of God. He is coming, and he's coming quickly. Tomorrow I'll talk about it a little more, even about those who have already died and those of us who are alive in the resurrection or the rapture of the church. But right now we need to know, comfort, encourage, strengthen one another with a fullness of the truth of God's love. Let's pray. Father, in this time, let us not be troubled about the end times. Let us not be fearful, but strengthen our lives. Help us to learn how to edify, to build up, and to encourage one another to see your glorious message of truth shine through us in the midst of what the world is seeing now that points toward the end time. Let them see your light in our hearts, your comfort in our voices, and your strength in our daily living. I give you praise for it, Lord, today in Jesus' name. Now, folks, turn in tomorrow. We're going to talk a little more about this and the rapture. God loves you. God's intent for you is tremendous. If you're not saved, you need to be. You can ask the Lord into your heart even right now. Pray a simple prayer. Lord, I believe you. Jesus, I ask you into my heart. I ask you to come in and save me. The Word of God declares if you believe in your heart, you make a confession with your mouth, you will be saved. We love you. Let us know what's going on. Contact us. Give us a message on our Facebook or go to ccoth.org. Connect with us and we'll bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.